All right, let's go to the psychologist finally. It's Lydia from Oceanside. Lydia, what's up?
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Yeah, I wanted to let you know that I am a clinical psychologist. Mm-hmm. And two master's degrees and a PhD.
Mm-hmm.
And I love you guys. I went to see a comedy show at Jones Beach, but I have to say, Anthony.
Yes.
Therapy would do you a world of good.
Now, why is that?
Well, I'm not saying you're right. You know, what you were saying to Ginger is 100% correct. You do have to be safety conscious. But what Patrice is saying makes a lot of sense. I think it's just a little over the edge with you. I personally
is taxi driver
back to that. I'm sorry?
It's taxi driver-ish.
I'm not doing that.
Right, exactly, exactly. I personally think it dates back to that feeling of vulnerability in the tree fort.
That was sexy, not vulnerable.
I didn't know that was sexy for you, Anthony.
You know, I'm just being safe. Why is it when someone wants to be safe and not be victimized that they're crazy?
You're preparing. This mm-hmm. is why you're crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You're preparing for a. You have escalated a paranoid delusion
mm-hmm.
to where you're prepared for that paranoid delusion. You're not prepared. Safety is a seatbelt. Safety is put that cigarette out. Safety is imminent. But you're not in any imminent danger from a guy breaking in your home.
But that's what people are never prepared for, non-imminent danger. People are never prepared for it, and they are the worst. Being a victim like that would be the worst life-ruining, devastating thing that could happen to somebody.
I want to know why she thinks you're crazy, though.
Yeah.
She's just touching.
Oh, thank you.
Because Anthony is prepared, and I agree with him that you have to be safety conscious. I live in Nassau County.
I just said all that already. Why is Anthony crazy?
Because he's more than prepared. He's obsessed.
No, I'm just talking about it here on the air. But it isn't.
I wouldn't say
it isn't how I'd lead.
But
my,
this is well thought out. Is
but
what
I don't,
she's getting at.
At some point, I thought it out.
I think just about every person listening.
But I don't lead my life on a daily basis, going through drills and marching around the house with my guns.
Actually, you have to be.
I bet
to
you
prepare
he's,
your woman and your cat.
I bet you he has rolled off his bed a few times. Like
he has to
roll.
I have never.
Cover. First of all, you
never rolled off.
What are you, 58? You're 58?
58. Jesus Christ, I'm not even close to the 50.
You have to practice some type of muscle memory to slide a 58-year-old body off the bed to grab his gun from out of the floor.
Hey, Anthony's working out these days.
Did you see? You want to see the guns?
Let's see the guns.
You want... Look at
Whoa.
The guns.
Whoa.
Look at the guns.
Thurston Howell had the same arms on Gilligan's Island.
Look at the guns.
My guns. Why, Anthony, why do you need more than one gun?
Because there's more than one room.
He's showing off his muscles, dearie.
What am I going to say if they break in downstairs? I'm going to say, could you excuse me while I go upstairs and get the gun to shoot you with? You gotta be prepared.
But there's a okay. What is the lifestyle?
Mm-hmm.
How many times a day?
Yeah.
Do you think on that level? Do you actually live
no.
your life?
Oh no, there are days, weeks go by where I don't even think about that. But if I'm asleep, and I hear something, I'll kind of lift my head up. I look around, and then I know. I go, okay, the gun's there. If that sound develops into anything else, I know where everything is.
See, yeah, you're crazy. I'm with
no,
you.
No, but that doesn't happen for like weeks.
You're overthinking it a little too much.
No, I'm not. Why? What are you, crazy?
We're with you on
you
a
would be
level.
Scared crapless if you were laying in bed and heard a window break downstairs and you hear some people coming and then you'd be like, what do I do? What? You'd be looking around with grabbing a pencil that
but
you hope to jab in the guy's
that's
eye.
That's what the average citizen would do.
The average citizen is a victim and an idiot.
You know what? You're preparing for a war.
On the North Shore.
Well, some weird war.
No, it's not a weird war. It's been called a certain type of war, but that's the one I'm preparing for. Sorry, Patrice.
I can't believe you said 52 home invasions a year. That is ridiculous.
I said a lot. If there was
just
one,
a lot out there.
If there was
this
one,
this isn't one of these just
but
every once in a
you
while.
Look, if you look at the news, all you see are Nassau County police cars with tape around a house. It's all the time.
Oh, my God.
There will be tape around my house, but it'll be me out front giving the interview.
Why don't you live in the city?
The city doesn't allow you to have guns.
He needs guns, Patrice.
But you don't worry about that at all, right? Because
nah.
You live in a building.
Nah, you got
a
doorman and stuff.
A security guard.
I don't want a security guard.
Have someone just walk
the perimeter.
Ever
hear something called an inside job?
Just walk. Have someone walk the perimeter every night.
Why have a security guard when you have security cameras?
You can get Kenny to walk
and
the
you
perimeter.
You can look.
Thank you. Hey, Kenny, how much does it cost to do
security
for a year? Personal security, your person's security guard.
Not even.
Or bodyguard, 24
just
hours a day.
Overnight security from, let's say, 6, 7 o'clock at night to 6, 7 in the morning.
The going rate is $50 an hour.
That's it?
$50 an hour, and you can get someone walking
in your booth that I build in front of the driveway?
Right.
And just $50 an hour?
Right.
To sit in a car outside his place and walk the perimeter every once in a while. There you go.
So $600 a day?
Yeah.
To be a sentry.
That's nothing.
All right. Thank
you.
You're
the date.
Lydia.
Your bullets cost more.
Thank you, guys.
All right.
Residential burglaries. 1,093 in Nassau County. 1,093 residential burglaries. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean...
Last year?
...that people were home at the time. But I'm looking
home
for...
home invasions.
Home
most
invasion.
Of the time, you got to understand, home invasion is a life sentence, man. Most of the time, people are not trying to rob you while you're at home because they're going to jail for the rest of their life.
Yeah, but if that door is open, if that, you know, that sliding door or a window is open, that's when you got trouble.
I bet you you invite, in some weird way, you invite a home invasion. Like,
no.
You got candy, Xboxes. On
I do not.
He got something going on. He just
what
wants.
I did.
Hey, man, most of the callers and when people, right now agree with Anthony.
When
so.
Strangers are in my house, like the cleaning people or something, I will then go around the entire house and make sure all my windows are locked because I don't want somebody going, click, I'll leave that open for later. See, so I'm not inviting a home invasion. I make sure I lock all the windows
you're
again.
You're overthinking it, just like Lydia
no!
said.
No! What if...
Let's go to Jimmy in
Holy
Boston.
Holy jeez, you're all victims! You're victims waiting to happen.
All right, calm down.
Sheep!
I told you already, calm down.
I'm the wolf,
take a
not
breath.
The sheep.
Take a breath.
Okay.
Jimmy in Boston listening on BCN, the home of Toucher and Rich. What's up, Jimmy?
What's going on, guys?
Hey, man.
Hey, I just wanted to, like...
Toucher's home intoxication, which is almost like home invasion, only drunk.
Yeah, he gets around situations by just handing out beer to everybody. Let's just have a
they
party.
They just drink together.
Let's just have a party.
Everyone leaves happy.
Right. All right, Jimmy, what do you got?
Hey, I was just thinking, I mean, do you guys think it's crazy the families that come up with escape routes and meeting places that are in, like, a home fire are crazy?
Mm-hmm.
No, that's fine.
They're kind of just, you know, preparing for something that's not common, you know?
How do you prepare your kid for Negroes coming through your front door and trying to kill you?
Well, your kids are very difficult. You don't want to turn them off to, you know, different cultures. But somebody as jaded as me, who was brought up in a predominantly racist household,
right?
You know, it's had its effect on me.
I just said, you've never had a black person, let me tell you something, you've never had a black person do anything wrong to you ever that's changed your life.
No, that's
never.
That's not true.
You've never had a black person do anything.
I went to Central Islip school district.
Punch you in your stomach?
It was like
traumatic, dude. Like
being stabbed.
On this level where you're worried about black people.
Oh, no.
And
you know something? I want that to continue.
All right, listen, let me ask you this before we go to break.
Yeah.
Do you want a home invasion to happen?
He does.
No.
Thank you.
It would be the most frightening thing. And I think if I killed somebody, I would be a changed person. It's not a good thing to kill people. It would haunt you. You know, it would just haunt me. I don't want it, but I am not going to. I think what's more traumatic than killing someone that has invaded your home is sitting there during those moments watching the horror that is ensuing as you and your loved ones are being tortured, perhaps killed. And you are powerless. That's the thing, is being powerless. I am not going to be a victim. I will fight it out till the end, till somebody's dead. That's how it's got to work, because I'm not going to sit there and then have it all end and go through years of this.
In his paranoia, it's at the highest level. Mm-hmm. Because it doesn't even involve maybe not being killed. Maybe just being robbed.
I don't want to be robbed. I don't want anyone in my goddamn house.
But of course not. But if they get the bead on you, you got to be thinking, all right, look, just take this little bit of money.
No, that would traumatize me worse than shooting somebody. Would be me getting strangled or pistol whipped, getting my possessions taken in front of me. Having people just come and then go and they're gone, having a great old time after they just robbed me and perhaps they're off robbing somebody else, that would kill me. I couldn't live like that. I'd live better having shot somebody.
It's to the death.
It's to the death.
That's what he said, to the
death.
It's
to the death. Once it passes my doorway, to the death.
All right, it's the Opie and Anthony Show.